sort of get that feeling. But basically what you're looking for, and I think this might even be, so it's not perfectly centered. If you see my hands, they're still moving. So what you want is for your hands to be able to sit on top of the clay while it's moving, but not actually, your hands actually stay still. So did that make sense, the up and then the down? After you, ma'am.
So how would you get, like, you know, let's say, like,
that comes after the centering, and I can show you that once you feel comfortable with centering. So you're going to use this part of your hand over here to kind of curl in, give it an undercut, not a deep one, and then once you've got a little undercut, start raising it up gently but firmly at the same time. And also maybe brace your elbows again.
Yeah.
So your arms are the control. Your arms keep your hands from moving, and et cetera, et cetera. Physics! You like physics. How old are you? You even know what physics are! And you know what physics means? Like, the science of motion and energy and things like that. So are you, like, a genius then? Clearly. No, clearly you're a genius. I've officially declared you a genius. So, you want to really... Another thing, you always want to work from the bottom up. You never want to go up and down. So use the heel here and squeeze it just a little more. And then just really pull. It's stuck to the heel, so it's not going anywhere. But pull slowly. Do you mind if I do hand over hand? So we're going to go like that. Do you feel it coming up? Yeah. And we're going to keep moving our hands up, otherwise we're going to end up cutting the clay into two pieces. And then once you're up, get some more water, and then boom, push it back down. Again, keep your fingers together. So you're already up, you want to go down next. So thumbs over, and then keep those fingers together, and press down, keep your elbows or your forearm braced on that splash pan there. And then you're just going to push. The ultimate shape you're looking for is basically like a little cupcake. You can like, yeah, you got it, basically. So I'll let you start opening it up. So to do that, you're going, see this little divot I just made? You're going to take, I'm not going to open it up for you, but I'll show you. You're going to take your sponge over your knuckles, because friction is your enemy, and you're going to press your fingers not directly in the center. You're not trying to poke a hole. You're trying to sort of gradually create a decline. So you're going to just press gradually downwards. Eventually you'll feel that it's centered, your fingers are centered in there. And then depending on what you want to make, you can either leave that and start pulling, or you can actually, once you've reached the bottom or however far from the bottom you end up getting, you can actually pull the clay out directly towards you, and you'll end up making sort of a bowl shape like that. Okay. So here's the sponge. Have fun. I'm a mess. So I also have a booth, booth 15, and there are 6 stations there for building with air dry clay, and I've got acrylic paint. Right now, one of my favorite art teachers in the world is covering for me. But if you don't get a chance to try the mill, because I might break down a little earlier than 3 o'clock just because it's kind of messy, if you don't get a chance to try the wheel, check out 15. You can do some hand building, and I also do in-home pottery lessons. This is a portable wheel. You can grab my business card. So again, muscle is so weirdly important. You gotta really push. There you go. So you're gonna push, push, push. That's about as far down as you need to go. And then if you want to make it a bowl, just right from here, pull directly towards you slowly. And yeah, keep sponging that. Use as much water as you need. When I first started out with pottery in college, my professor was like, the less water the better. Another thing is you always want to work either on the front or on, are you left-handed?
I'm right-handed.
Okay, cool. So you always want to work with your hands on the front or on the right side. If you're working on this side, you're working against the drag of the clay, and you'll end up probably tearing it or something along those lines. But yeah, so you got it opened up. Do you want me to show you how to do a pull?
Yeah.
All right, so to make it taller or wider, depending on what you're going for, it really all depends on the pressure you put on your inside and outside hand. So I'm going to do one really minor pull to show you, and then you can just explore working with the rest of it. So what you do, we're going to do a side pull. You're going to dig your fingers in underneath here so you get that little uppercut. Your inside hand is going to be just slightly above your outside hand. Be very careful how much pressure you put on them. Right. Or tear it off completely. And you're literally just going to very grandma do?
She, I don't know, she just had a lot of grit.
Nice, dude, you're a cool grandma. But yeah, so you can just keep on pulling. You can compress the rim just like that in order to keep it kind of solid. None of these pieces are going to survive this fest. These are all going to get recycled just because it's going to be too much of a pain to get them done, frankly. But basically, if you were to be making a pot that you really wanted to use, there would be a bunch of compression and things like that, which you're actually pulling with your fingers down there, which is great. Don't hold your fingers in one place too long while you're pulling, or it will thin out that wall really, really fast. And if it feels like it's about to crumble or flop down, feel free to just splat it.
Start over.
Keep playing it. You got as much time as you want on this.
So I just flop it down if it feels like it's
Yeah, if it feels like it's not going anywhere with you, just you can just flop it back down. Yep. And then if you want, take a minute to just kind of explore the mess. I'm personally a fan of mud.